So for these questions, I expect you guys to have the Big Daddy flowchart printed out next to you, because I'm not going to be able to move back and forth between pages because I just want to stay on this page, but I will guide you through it as it's next to you, all right? So what mechanism did you guys get for this question? Hopefully what you got was SN2, okay? If you used the flowchart correctly, that should have been the right mechanism. Let me go ahead and walk you guys through it. So what's the first question that we always ask on the flowchart, okay? I know that I have a nucleophile, I know that I have a leaving group, so I know that I should use that flowchart. And the first question is it negatively charged or is it neutral? What do you guys think about Nash? Is Nash negative or is it neutral? It should be negative, right? Because remember that sodium, Na, is going to dissociate into Na positive and SH minus. So that means that I do have a negatively charged nucleophile. It's SH minus, so I'm going to go down the left side of my flowchart. So let's keep going. Second question, is SH minus one of my bulky bases? Yes or no? No. Remember, there's only three bulky bases. You have to memorize those. Don't think about it too hard, just memorize them. SH minus is not one of them. So then let's go to my third question. Third question going down is what type of leaving group do I have? So my leaving group is this bromine here. What type of leaving group is that? That would be secondary. Why? Because the carbon that it's attached to has two R's coming off of it. Okay? So that would be secondary. What does that mean? That means we have to ask ourselves one last question. Because secondary doesn't tell you a mechanism right away. You have to ask yourself one last question. Is it one of my strong bases? Remember that we had a list of five strong bases or four bases plus heat that we needed to figure out. So do we have any of those conditions? So is SH minus on my bases list? No, it's none of the four bases. Is 20 degrees Celsius on my heat list? Do you guys know how hot 20 degrees Celsius is? It's probably colder than the room that you're in right now, okay? Room temperature is 25 degrees Celsius, so unless you like it really cold in your room, it's probably warmer than 20 degrees Celsius. So that would not be hot. So we would say that it's not going to be E2, it's not a base, it's going to prefer to be a nucleophile. So this is going to be, I'm just going to say here, nucleophile is going to equal SN2. Does that logic make sense? So see how that's cool how you didn't actually need to understand that much, even though I know that, like I said, it sounds weird that I don't want you to understand it, but there's so many complexities that a lot of times it's just better if we just let the flowchart take over. All right, so now that I know it's SN2, now that was just the first step. Now I have to draw the mechanism and I have to predict the products. Thankfully, SN2 is a really easy reaction. All I'm going to do is backside attack. So I take my SH minus and I draw my arrow coming from the back of wherever the alkyl halide is. That's actually important. If this is a free response exam and you drew your arrow, just showing you, if this was free response and you drew your arrow like this, your professor could actually dock points because that's not a backside attack, that's a frontside attack. You have to draw from the opposite direction. So you do this, okay? And if we make a bond, we have to break a bond, so we're going to break the bond to the bromine. What you should have gotten for your last product or for your final product is just one product, and what would have been the stereochemistry? Everything else would have been the same. Notice that those were chiral centers as well, but that's not where the reaction took place, so those stay exactly the way they are. But now I would get inversion of configuration on, oops, that's the wrong thing, not with Br, but with SH, because SH was my nucleophile. So that was, we used the flowchart to determine the mechanism, then we drew the mechanism, and then we drew the product. And if you guys did that, I'm like more than impressed. You guys are doing awesome. If you got stuck at one of those steps, that's okay, because I still have five more practice problems for you. So got plenty of time to get better. All right? So let's go ahead and do the same thing for problem number two.